All right, what's going on YouTube? Card Collector 2 coming at you here with a brand new video, and this is going to be a multi-part series where we are going to talk all about the National, right? So if you are new to cards and you've never been, this is the mecca for sports card shows. This is really the best of the best, right? You'll hear many collectors, including myself, really the hobby veterans, and talk all about really what this show is and what it's become over the last couple years. So the National was started back in, I believe, 1980. You can read more about this on the National website, which is nsccshow.com, but it was out in LA. I believe it was in Anaheim in a little Marriott out there near the airport, and really started, that's where the National started. But now this is really the biggest sports card show in the world. This show has anybody and everybody in cards at this event. Anybody from, you got your vintage and modern collectors, you've got your grading companies, you've got your auction houses, you've got everybody. So this is really the big one. This is the show that is the best of the best. So we're going to hit on a couple different points throughout a couple different videos. At the moment, this will likely be probably a three-part series where we talk in different points on different sections. So if there's something you want us to answer, feel free to drop a comment down below and we will try to get it in one of the upcoming videos. But today, we are going to talk all about what the National is, admission, dates, hours, parking, hotels, and then we may get into some other stuff at the end if time permits. So one of the more important things about the show is going to be the hotels. The nicest part about Chicago, in my opinion, it is the best venue for this show for that reason, right? Is there are four hotels directly across the street. I believe it's like Embassy, Crown, Doubletree, and Hilton. I don't know the names off the top of my head, but I know there's four directly across the street from the front door, and then there's a Hyatt Regency O'Hare directly on the side of the building. So essentially, you've got five hotels within 100 yards of the front door. That is great. Not only for peace of mind that you can walk out of your hotel room and walk across the street, and you know it's a 10-15 minute walk at most if you're on the top floor in the farthest corner. That is very nice. But the ability also that when you leave the hotel, there's places, there's people, and there's a lot of the social aspect outside of the show makes it so fun, right? I've been to the last 10 Nationals before this, and that's one thing I can always say is there's always something going on at night with so many hotels close by, right? It's great for kids because kids aren't, you know, having to get in an Uber and drive 30 minutes away like some of the other venues, i.e. what happened in Cleveland. But with Chicago, you're right across the street, you're right next door, there's always something going on. So being so close in proximity to some of these trade nights or things that happen in lobbies or hotel ballrooms after the hours is great. I would assume a lot of those hotels are booked up at this point. I booked ours in March and they were almost sold out there. So I would assume a lot of those are sold out, but I know good news is there's a lot of hotels on that main road right there. So I would encourage you to check one out. Always can take an Uber in, but if you have to drive and you have to park, good news is there's a parking garage directly across the street. Should have, I believe it's about 8,000 parking spaces according to their website. It looks like parking's about $15 from what I saw online, $15 a day. That's a 24-hour period with no ins and outs according to the website. So 15 bucks, you can walk right across the street. It's right next to one of, it's in between two of the hotels. So that's nice, the peace of mind to be able to leave the show and park right there for only a couple bucks isn't bad. In terms of the hours, the show officially kicks off on the VIP sneak peek night, which is Wednesday. That's gonna run from 4 to 8 p.m. according to their website. And that is going to be for anyone that's purchased a VIP pass through the National. That's a ticket pass to get into the show. We'll hit more on that in just a second. But for anyone that's got a VIP, you can get in that day. I also believe now, this is probably a good question for the website, but I'm fairly confident now that includes general admission. You can use general admission from 4 to 8 p.m. So I would verify that on the website, but that is my understanding for how I read it, was general admission could get in there. So you've got 4 to 8 on Wednesday, then you've got 10 to 6 Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and you've got 10 to 4 on Sunday. Now, as we transition into the ticket options, The one nice thing about the VIP, there's a VIP and there's a super VIP. The VIP options, both of those will allow you 30 minutes of early access to the show, right? So not only does it include the Wednesday sneak peek, which you don't have to buy admission for because it would be included in your pass, but you also get in 30 minutes early the other days. So 9:30 a.m. the rest of the week. Now, some people are like, hey, it's 30 minutes, it's 9:30, I'm gonna get breakfast. I understand that, but if you're trying to be there at 10, keep in mind, in years past, before the market or before the hobby was what it is today, you're waiting 10, 15, 20 minutes to get into the show. Now double that or triple that with the amount of people that will be at this show. It will be huge. At least that's what we anticipate, right? So if that's the case, could it be 15, 20, 30 minutes to get in with general admission at 10 a.m.? Might make sense to look at some of the passes, right? I know I've looked in the past at I believe the VIP, just the general VIP is $139.99. Probably should have checked this before, but I'm fairly confident that's what it is. And then the super VIP is $199 if pre-ordered through the website. And I know there's a limited number of these. But the VIP, right, each of these passes is gonna come with exclusive bonuses, right? So I haven't purchased one of these in a minute, so don't quote me on all of these. Make sure you check out nsccshow.com. But I know with each pass, you're gonna get individual promotional packs from each of the companies. This is how it's been in the past. And I think I should preface that now before we go on much farther, that I am speaking on 10 years of experience at the show. 10 straight years, 2009 to 2019, didn't miss a show. Some of this can change with COVID and everything going on this year, right? I can speak to my 10 years of experience, but I can't speak to how companies may adapt in this new age of, you know, cards, with demand being at an all-time high and popularity being so high, and then COVID in this. I'm not sure. So I'm speaking to what I've been able to experience in 10 years. Not necessarily, I've never had conversations with any of these companies about their plans. This is just what I've been able to learn and capture in 10 years. So keep that in mind, that some of this may change as these companies make announcements for their plans post when these videos are released. So just keep that in mind. I would encourage you to continue to check out the website. But going back to what I said earlier, again, the 30 minutes, that has been helpful to be able to get into the show, right? Because one thing that people may overlook is, we'll get into this in later videos, but Rapper Redemptions with Panini, if they do the silver packs where you buy a box and get a silver bonus pack, right? The redemption trade up, right? Where you can redeem old redemptions. That's another thing Panini's done in the past, right? A lot of those lines form pretty early. Topps does their pack giveaways. Other companies do on-site grading, right? Beckett has done RCR in the past. Will PSA do on-site grading? It sounds like they will, right? A lot of those lines form early, right? So if you're intending to get some of those things done, oftentimes it will be beneficial to be one of the first in line. The VIP, the 30 minutes, you'd beat all of general admission. That might be worth it to you if you only, especially if you're on a time crunch, right? If you've only got 1 or 2 days to accomplish a lot and you're 50th back in general admission, that line might be twice as long, right? So something to really consider there is, what's that worth to you? But going back to the point I was mentioning earlier, these packs, a lot of the ones in the VIP and the super VIP, they're gonna be like bonus 5-card packs where they're almost identical. Like, I think they're identical in every single one. So if, you know, cameraman Brian buys a VIP and he gets a free pack from Topps, a free pack from Upper Deck, a free pack from Panini, a free pack of Leaf, all of our packs will be the same, right? So the Panini one might have Trevor Lawrence, Justin Field, Zach Wilson, LeBron James, and Tiger Woods or Serena Williams, whatever it may be. I would assume those are probably gonna be Upper Deck athletes, but you get the idea, right? So it'll have 5 different cards and everybody's packs will be the same. Upper Deck will have, like I said, you know, it'll be Tiger, LeBron, Jordan, Serena, somebody else, and it would be a 5-card pack that would be the same in every one. Sometimes they're 2, 4, 5, 6 card packs, typically a little drawstring book bag, a little lanyard that says VIP, and etc. Typically the super VIP comes with double what the VIP does in terms of those packs. That's how it's been in the past. Again, don't know this year. Those details have yet to be, you know, informed from my understanding, but if you got a super VIP, you would get 2 Panini packs, 2 Topps packs, 2 Leaf packs, whatever was in the pack, you would just get double that. In addition to the VIP, The bonus is there. You also get autograph tickets as well. So the sneak peek night, I believe it's typically 3:30. In the past, it's been run by Topps, is my understanding. I know in 2019, Josh Luber from StockX and Gary Vee were on like a fireside chat panel before. I think it was about 3:30. You get admission to that, and then there's like autograph signings that are included. You get tickets with the VIP and the super VIP. Typically, the VIP gets like 12 of the 18 tickets, right? The super VIP would get all 18 tickets. Now, keep in mind, these autograph signers, I've touched on this before. This isn't Tom Brady, Peyton Manning, and LeBron James. This is, I was scrolling on the list here earlier in terms of the guests. Some of the guys mentioned are, I think this might be from last year, but some of the ones I saw on the website were like Jack Clark, Calvin Murphy. This one mentions Charlie Joyner, Cecil Cooper, Jack Clark, Dexter Jackson, Billy Shaw. I don't know who some of those people are. I'm assuming some of the younger crowd doesn't know who some of those people are. I personally, again, I've bought in the VIP pass before and I've never gone to the party. Again, I've talked about it. I would prefer to be at the show, wheeling and dealing. Typically, I'm looking for the deals first day of the show. So it might not be for everybody, but that's something that's typically included. Additionally, in the past, there's a VIP lounge where you can go and get snacks and refreshments throughout the show. Again, never something I've personally taken advantage of. I think I did it one time in like Baltimore, one of my first trips out. Took a little break there and it was cool, but that's been 10, 11 years since I've done that. So not something I can speak too much of. Likely somebody that's taken advantage of that that can speak to it. But again, something that's happened in the past. So 30 minutes early with the VIP every day, access to the VIP, the sneak peek night on Wednesday, 4 to 8 p.m. Again, show runs Wednesday through Sunday. So that is a lot about that. Last thing to keep in mind with the VIP is easy in, easy out. Just typically in the past, it's just been to show your badge, walk in and out. Advantage there, when you have general admission, typically gotta get your hand stamped, wait in line for that. Makes it a little trickier. Not necessarily a big deal, but something to keep in mind. All right, and then last but not least for this video, a question I get asked a lot is, if you could only go for one day, if you could only go for 2 days, what days would you pick, right? So I think this question is very important to everybody individually, right? If you have a kid, oftentimes I've said in the past, the best day to go is Saturday. There's typically the most going on Saturday. I know that people at Panini have typically run kids breaks on Saturdays in the past. Again, I'm not gonna hold Panini to that. I'm not sure they'll run those again, but in the past, kids breaks, the free kids breaks they do have been on Saturdays. That's oftentimes a nice advantage for parents to be able to go and try to partake in that. Saturday is just when you would expect the most people who aren't working to be there. So typically Saturdays are the best day. They're also the busiest, right? Again, if you're working through the week, the day you can go is likely Saturday or Sunday. Saturday has typically always been the busiest day. If you're like me and you're going to go through dollar boxes and wheel and deal, right, and match your goal for the show, then personally, I like to be as early as possible. So my best day would say Wednesday, right? I'd go Wednesday for half a day and I'd stay through Thursday. I would try to be as close to the start as possible. Really just depends on, like I said, what you're trying to accomplish in your time at the National, right? If you're trying to get a couple cards graded, go through some boxes and buy a PC card you've always wanted, that makes more sense to go towards the front of the show. If you're trying to get a Barry Sanders autograph, if he shows up to the show and he does autographs or whoever it may be, might make more sense for you to go on the weekend. Really just depends on what your plan is. So can't really answer the best day for you, but again, that's typically the way I lean. Kids packs, more of a just hang out and enjoy it, slower paced, go on the weekends, go a little bit later. If you're trying to go through boxes, find deals, make some stuff happen, the sooner rather than later is what I would say. Keeping in mind that certain things happen on certain dates. So if Barry Sanders or some Hall of Famer, there will be autograph signers. In the past, it's been through TriStar. If TriStar has Barry Sanders is likely not there Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. He's likely there Thursday only. So depending on who you might want, that might require some planning in terms of getting there for that particular autograph guest. So something to keep in mind when you're trying to plan out your trip would be, what are you trying to accomplish? And that's one thing I would hit on this as we wrap this video up is this is overwhelming. I've talked about this plenty of times. My understanding is the requirement to host a national is about 500,000 contiguous square feet. These are massive buildings filled with everything cards, everything collectibles, anything about the hobby, right? So you walk in and you're just immediately overwhelmed. Anything and everything is there. There's a saying that if you can't find it at the national, they probably didn't make it. So when you walk in, it's just so easy to get sidetracked, right? There's a Babe Ruth game used jersey here, and PSA's great in here, and Panini's got these cool packs here, and Barry Sanders is in the building to sign. I don't know why I've got this infatuation with Barry Sanders today, but if Barry Sanders is there to sign, right, there's a lot going on. So when you walk in, if you've never been and you have no idea what you want to accomplish, that might be okay too, but if you are on a time crunch, you've got one day, you've got 2 days, might make sense to plan these things out because it's very easy to walk in there and just go every which way, right? This table, then this table, then this table, and all of a sudden you're halfway through the day and you haven't accomplished anything, at least not that you wanted to, because there's just so much going on. This isn't your slow, you know, 25, 30 table show that's right down the road. This is the mecca of sports card shows. Having an idea of what you want to accomplish from the start might not be a bad thing. So something to keep in mind. In the upcoming videos, we're going to talk about how to succeed at the National. We're gonna talk about things that you might not be thinking about that you should bring. In 10 years, I can tell you there are some things that a lot of people would overlook and why those are important, more important than you might believe to bring those. We'll talk about exclusives at the National, on-site grading, VIP parties, gold or silver packs. We'll get into that and so much more. Appreciate you guys watching. Next video is coming soon.